My biggest inspiration, I would say, is like my grandmother and my mother. And I guess you could throw my biological dad in there. He plays bass, or whatever case may be, and he was really into funk music, right? But then my grandma, she's really into Dusties and soul music, so like B.B. King and Muddy Waters, and right? And then, but my mom, she's like Gerald Levert, Luther Vandross, Temptations, and so it's all those things. And not to mention, also, Chicago is house music central. You know, you see on Twitter, like when they say, oh, you wake up and you smell the pine saw and gospel music or house music playing. Yeah, that's every Saturday or Sunday in my household. I didn't really get into hip-hop, or my mom didn't even let me listen to hip-hop until I was about like 12, 13. I can't even tell you the first album, but I can tell you the first singles. It was Hot In Here by Nelly and In Those Jeans, just through listening to radio. You know what I'm saying? I didn't have no iPod or MP3 player, so it's like just riding around in the car with like my grandma, or they're just throwing, you know, Power 92, because they're like, oh, this is what the young kids like to listen to. And so those were the records that was popping at the time. My mom was like mad supportive, you know what I mean? But she's always been an advocate for like Plan B. She's never been one to like, yo, this is cool what you want to do, right? But you gotta have something on the side to quell my worries and to make sure you're good in on the back end in case it doesn't work out. So I went to SIU, Southern Illinois, Carbondale. I graduated, I got a degree in journalism. I went to college, next step. Then I eventually meet the guys who I formed this collective with, and we create music together and we become like best friends and brothers. So college afforded me that, if anything. And I feel like outside of the degree that I received and the loans that I racked up, the most important thing that I did was go to college, go there, and meet the guys that I eventually would go on to make music with and get us to this point. Look, first and foremost, if any of my West Side friends are watching this, I love y'all. You know I love y'all. Uncle Remus, I love Uncle Remus, right? It's not Harold's, right?
What?
It's, Uncle Remus is just ain't Harold's. I had debates with my West Side friends all the time. And this is a 50-year-old debate in Chicago. West Side, South Side. It is a 50-year-old debate. If you go to Harold's, two things you can get. You can get a 6-piece lemon pepper mild sauce, right? Or you can get the cat and wing combo. People sleep on the Harold's catfish. Harold's catfish, low-key, high key, underrated. If they not rude to you in Harold's, it ain't right, bro. Don't go to no Harold's that's nice to you. If they nice and they like complimentary and they're nice, don't eat there, it's trash. Go somewhere else. If it don't got the burglar bars or the bulletproof glass, it ain't good. Run as far as you can, it's not gonna be good. If you go over on 73rd, y'all know what I'm talking about, 73rd and Stony Island, some of the best Harold's in the city. Peep 75th and King Drop, some of the best girls in the, I'm just saying, if you grew up on Toonami, which most of us did, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you were just introduced to Dragon Ball Z, and it was just like, it was the cool thing to watch after like 7 o'clock, like on Cartoon Network. It just was what it was. I had keys to my apartment when I was like 7, right? So that means, and my mom wouldn't come home until like 10, 11 o'clock, she was working late night. So I'm at 7, I had to learn how to cook, whatever case may be. What I would do, I would go in the crib, right? Build me a little fort, you feel me? Turn on Toonami, mom's still not home, lock the doors and stuff like that, make sure all that's good. And I'm watching Dragon Ball Z. Like, that was just what it was. And it's like, you see Cowboy Bebop, Trigun, and Dragon Ball Z, you're like, whoa. Like, this ain't nothing like American cartoons, you know what I'm saying? You see blood, you see people getting hemmed up, you like, yo, this is different. If we're talking about as a longtime anime fan, Dragon Ball Z is obviously a given, right? That's automatic. Like, If you keeping up with Super, you know how lit Super is right about now. You know what I'm saying? Some people are Naruto fans, some people aren't. And I'm not trying to be cliche. I'm the, you know, people like Naruto, oh, that's the go-to anime. Nah. I'm talking about, I read the mangas. I know Shippuden. I remember Naruto when it first came on. I got some of the old, like, original mangas, like when Chapter 1 and stuff. So those are the shoo-ins. Now, recently, there was this anime called Erased. It's crazy. You gotta watch it. It's a great anime. I'm also watching Blood Battlegate or Hero Academia, dope. I'm recently started getting into this anime called Black Clover, that's dope. Seven Deadly Sins, if you've seen that, that's dope. Log Horizon, I don't know if people know what Log Horizon is. I'm working on my album. We're working on getting some shows together. Been getting a lot of requests to do shows and stuff like that because people want to kind of hear, you know, the EP live. So we may do throw some shows just to give people that live experience and just trying to make, you know, the best content we can, you know, the best music we can